I can't tell you how many times I talked to people about Abby and her situation and what happened that they never thought of that before. And especially being at a daycare provider's home where they are licensed by the state and regulated by the state. I'd never heard of it happening before. She was 19 months old, just shy of 19 months old when it happened. You know, she was walking, but then she started running and would run down the hall and come and see me when I'm getting ready for work. And she'd get her blanket and come sit on my lap and cuddle with me in the mornings before I'd have to take her to the babysitter. And I dropped her off and Rebecca, our oldest, at the babysitter's house. And I always would go and put her in the high chair, gave her a kiss. I remember that and told her I loved her and that I'd see her after work. Went to work, normal day, just like you'd think. And then decided at lunchtime that I needed to go home. I had planned to go home and do some things. And I sat at the stoplight at the intersection that I could either turn right and go see my kids for my lunch, or I could turn left and go home and do what I needed to do. The first thought was, I should go see the kids. But then, no, I'm gonna go home. I need to do this other stuff. You always think, if I woulda, coulda, shoulda, that's one of those moments. I was at home and I just finished doing the laundry, doing the dishes, and decided to go check my email while I was eating my pizza. And the phone rang, my cell phone rang, went and grabbed it. And every time I go to grab it, my heart always skips a beat when it's the babysitter, because I'm always thinking something's wrong with my kids. And I answer the phone thinking she's just calling to chat today. And she was crying and she couldn't get the words out of her mouth that she had told me that my daughter had a cord wrapped around her neck and she wasn't breathing. I didn't quite hear her, what she had said, and made her repeat it. And I told her I was on my way. So I got back in my car and I drove to her house trying to get a hold of my husband because he worked out of town. Wasn't able to get a hold of him and got a hold of my mom. When I got there, the paramedics were there, but there was no ambulance and there was some police officers still there, but they had already transported her to the hospital. The officers wouldn't let me go in the home. They kept me outside. When they said that she was at the hospital, they took me in the squad car, drove as slow as you could possibly go. I mean, I thought they should have at least turned the lights on. You know, this is an emergency. Why are you not getting me there faster? And when I got there and they took me in where they were working on her, my husband was 4 hours from home and I had to wait for him to come. And in the process of waiting for him to come, my daughter, they pronounced her dead. And I'd just be there with my mom, and the family members came and I held her, and then we had to leave her there. It's a day by day thing. You know, every day could be, one day you're fine, the next day you're crying. And even though it's been 7 years, it still seems like it was almost yesterday, but it never does ever go back to the way that you were. Abby would be turning 9 this February, just not having her here, wondering what her personality would be like now. You don't take your kids for granted anymore because you never know if they're going to be there the next day. You know, it makes you look at them a whole different way than what you used to. I've been able to since have 2 other children now where I've been able to stay home with them and be with them and be able to have those moments that I'm missing out on from not having Abby here. I think as a family, it has brought our family a lot closer together. Nothing with cords. In my home now, I have cellular shades that the cords are completely covered, don't even see them, or I have drapes. Now I can see that I would be asking if they had the proper type of window coverings in their home without having the cords, no blinds. And if they did, I would be looking elsewhere for child care for my child. Shortening the cords isn't gonna do it. Hanging the cords up isn't gonna do it. Just not having them in your home would do it. Don't wait, because it could be tomorrow and you wouldn't have your child here.